Namaste and good morning. Here we are going to discuss about electricity, which is very essential in our life nowadays. Without electricity, it is very difficult to live. It is very difficult for us to live because we fully depending on electricity for all purposes. And before we go to the detailed study of electricity, we should understand what is current. As we have seen in the previous video, current is the flow of charges. Charges means positive and negative charges are there, and the current is flowing from positive to negative side. And how the current is flowing? That is, actually electrons are moving. Electrons means negative charges, and it has a tendency to move to the positive side. That means electrons are moving just opposite to that of the current, because when electricity was observed, no electrons was discovered at that time. That is why this kind of problem arises. So we make an assumption or convention that the current is flowing from positive to negative side, whereas electrons are moving from negative to positive side. Just they are oppositely moving. And this type of current we call it as conventional current. Conventional current. Current means the rate of flow of charges. How much charge is flowing for a particular time is indicated by the current. Thus we can define current as the rate of flow. Rate is indicated by time. Charge is indicated by Q, Q by T. Q is the symbol for charge. And the unit of charge is coulomb. Coulomb is the unit of charge and is expressed in capital letters. I, the current, is the rate of flow of charge. And the unit of current, current also we have to know, and is given by ampere. Current is given by ampere. Always write in capital letters. These are all on behalf of the scientist. We are noting these units. That is why we are writing in capital letters. Unit for current is ampere. Unit for charge is coulomb. Okay. And coulomb per second is also called as ampere. Right. Suppose a charge of 1 coulomb is passing for a time of 1 second in a circuit. 1 coulomb of charge is flowing for 1 second. So what will be the value of current? I is equal to 1 ampere, right? 1 coulomb by 1, that is equal to 1 ampere. Thus, how can we define 1 ampere? 1 ampere is the amount of current when a charge of 1 coulomb is flowing for a time of 1 second. Here. Relating to this, we can define this 1 ampere. 1 ampere is the amount of current, because ampere is the unit of current. So 1 ampere is the amount of current when 1 coulomb of charge is flowing for 1 second. This is how we can define this 1 ampere. Ampere means rate of flow of charge. Current is the rate of flow of charge, and the unit is ampere. Clear? How these charges can flow? That is the next question. In order to flow the charges, what are the conditions to be satisfied? The charges can flow only when, suppose, for example, I will give you a tank of water here. And this is another tank of water. Suppose I connect these two by a tube. Okay. Connected by a tube. Then that means here this is in a higher level and this is in a lower level. That means a pressure difference is maintained in order to flow the water through the tube. Right. Similarly, here also for the flow of charges, we need a difference in level. This level is called potential. Potential is the level, and the difference in potential is called potential difference. So a potential difference is required for the flow of current. And this potential difference is denoted by the unit volt. Volt is the unit for potential difference. So what is potential difference? Suppose we place a charge in an electric field, it experiences a force. Right, force on that electric field. In order to move that charge, it has to apply a force to oppose that field effect. Right. Similarly, here also a potential difference is required to for the continuous flow of current. So the potential difference is the amount of work done. A work is to be done. To carry a unit positive charge from one point to the other. Suppose these are the two points and the current is flowing through these points. An amount of work is to be done to carry a unit positive charge from one end to the other. That is meant by potential difference. And the unit is volt. As we have seen before, work done can be given by W, charge is given by Q. V is equal to W by Q. All these formulas are very, very important, and you should keep a separate book to note down these formulas, just like a pocketbook. That pocketbook will be help you to go for quick reference during the exam time. So keep a pocketbook with you with all these formulas, and it will make chapter wise you note down the formulas that will help you in your exam time or for, during revision time. Work done by charge. How can we define 1 volt? What is the unit of work done? Work done is given by the unit joule. right? So 1 joule by 1 coulomb. Then the work done is 1 joule and the charge flowing is 1 coulomb. Then the potential difference will be equal to 1 volt. So how can we define 1 volt? 1 volt is the potential difference when 1 joule of work is done to carry the charge of 1 coulomb. Clear? This is how we can define this potential difference. Let us do one problem related to this. How much energy is given to each coulomb of charge passing through a 6 volt battery? That is the question. Here, the term each coulomb means every 1 coulomb. So, the charge here is 1 coulomb. The potential difference given is 6 volt. Then it will be easy for us to calculate the work done. Okay. You apply the formula, substitute the values and find out the answer. Let us do the problem. Here Q is equal to 1 coulomb, V is equal to 6V. We know V is equal to W by Q, that is 6 is equal to W by 1. So the answer is 6 joules. We'll be with you with more problems and explanation. Thank you for watching. If you like my video, please like it and share it.